Hello, No Risk community. My name is Daryl Jasper, member here at No Risk, and I am here with our head coach, co-owner, and everything No Risk CrossFit, Judah Boulay. Playing off of a theme you just talked about, programming. The membership here, number of different professionals, different walks of life, different backgrounds, age ranges, we have it all here. How does that, when you talk about the community, how does that play into your method behind programming? I don't think all members have a chance to really maybe ask you that question. So what goes behind it? How much planning before we see these workouts appear on Heroic and we either gasp or grunt or groan or moan?
So I think that the way I differ from a lot of gyms is that the approach I take to programming is looking at who we have come in here. All right, so I realize that we have a lot of varied ages, a lot of varied walks of life, and we don't have a lot of hard-charging individuals who want to compete in the CrossFit game. So First and foremost, while all the CrossFit gyms might stress the Olympic movements or full-range Olympic movements, as you notice with my programming, a lot of my programming centers around power movements, power variety. I think the Olympic movements in terms of the power varieties are very functional and essential for everybody. You know, everybody needs to know how to have an explosive hip, no matter their age. You know, and just in terms of, oh, you're walking in the street and a car's charging at you, you know, you want to be able to jump out of that, out of the way of that as quickly as possible. I know that's kind of an extreme situation. So we do a lot of explosive hip movements. However, the power varieties generate that, but there's the limitations of flexibility or technique aren't as apparent with the power varieties. So I use a lot of those. I think strength is a foundation for anybody. So building functional strength, is there a limitation to how strong somebody probably needs to be? Yes, but that's for that individual to come to the conclusion themselves. And we offer strength work, and if somebody feels that building maximum strength is not there, you know, they don't want to do that, then they can talk to the coach or just scale back and work the movement, but not build that, you know, that maximum one rep max strength. And then with the conditioning pieces, I try to tailor it into the overall work of the week. And I try to balance as much anterior chain or front part of the body move as well as the back part of the body move. I try to balance as much push and pull. I kind of, for all, every single push there is with upper body, I try to get twice as much pull just for balance, especially with the males. Males tend to be very forward anterior or pec dominant. And to offset that, they need twice as much back work just because of the way males have worked out for a long period of time. So, and then I just try to balance out, you know, energy systems. You know, if people are going 20 minutes straight versus getting some intervals versus getting like a short, hard charging workout for 10 minutes. I try to balance it all. And then Saturdays, since we have larger classes, I try to make it a little bit more aerobic based and a little bit more mind grueling with the amount of work that's done, just because there's more people in the gym. The classes are always going to be big, and I think there's strength, individual strength from numbers around, and the larger the numbers around people, the more able they're going to be able to do a longer grueling workout. So, you know, I think there's great benefit to be gained from the short ones done at high intensity, and then there's great benefit to be gained from the long grueling workout, which is done, you know, slower and over a longer period of time. Everything has its place,
right? Yeah. Saturdays are, without a doubt, one of my favorite days of the week to come to the box.